जय श्री माता जी। आज उपस्थित सभी विश्व के सभी सहयोगियों भाई बहनों को आज के इस सुबह के ध्यान सत्र में हार्दिक स्वागत है। श्री माता जी को प्रणाम करके हम सामूहिक बंधन लेते हैं। इसी अवस्था को बनाए रखते हुए अब हम तीन महामंत्र और श्री गणेश मंत्र का उच्चारण करते हैं।
Thank you.
दोनों हथेली और तालू में संतुलन अवस्था की ओर देखना है। राइट हैंड तालू के ऊपर रखते हुए सहस्रार खुलने का अनुभव देखिए। राइट हैंड गोद में रखते हुए लेफ्ट हैंड से भी ये अनुभव चेक करें। लेफ्ट हैंड तालू के 2 इंच ऊपर सहस्रार चक्र की अनुभूति और हथेली में बहने वाला चैतन्य को देखिए। धीरे से हाथ नीचे ले। इसी अवस्था में अब हम कुछ क्षण ध्यान में बैठते हैं। इसी अवस्था में अब हम परम पूज्य श्री माता जी की अमृतवाणी आत्मसात करते हैं।
It is so great to be with you people today on this auspicious day, to be with Australians who have proved to be very good Sahajogis and who have progressed in a very speedy manner. In their spiritual life. It gives me greatest pleasure to be with my children here. As you know, I have so many children all over the world. Apart from the one whom I actually physically gave birth. We have to think of all those today who are away from us, thousands of miles. Praying to God Almighty for their spiritual ascent. One has to only pray for the spiritual ascent. Because as you ascend, you get all the rest of it. Because you do not ascend, you do not get what is needed. That's why there are problems. And even today I had to solve some problems before I could come to puja. But if you decide that we have to ascend spiritually within us, then everything that you have to receive, all the blessings that God wants to shower upon you, to make you the citizen of His great kingdom, where you are no more judged, you are no more chastised, you are no more put to any test, but where you reside in eternal love of God and in His glory. I could not believe about 10 years back that within 10 years I'll be able to achieve this result. You should not judge the progress of Sahaja Yoga in relation to other plastic gurus. Even to create one saint, we require 1,000 lives to pass. And so many have become prophets. It's a very big thing for them. Let us forget about what dents we have within ourselves. We have to know that we are prophets. This assumption has to be established, that we are prophets. If you could just assume what you are, what you have become, you will emit the glory of God. Like a flower when 8 blossoms. It has its fragrance, which flows automatically. But it's only human beings who have freedom, even not to assume, to dramatize, or to assume what they are. Even if they have become prophets, they still linger on with what they are not, in imagination, and are still frightened, are still ego-oriented. It's false. It's not your true nature. It's like acting in a drama, becoming the actor. Like somebody is acting like Shivaji. So he becomes as if he is Shivaji. So whole lifestyle, everything changes, he becomes Shivaji. But the same person, if he is acting like Hitler, he becomes like Hitler. Both are artificial. But artificial, they become. Now when you are really prophets, you find it difficult to be the real person, what you are. But artificial, which is gone back, which is no more there, it's all finished. The sinner is dead. The egoistical is not there. The frightened one is gone forever. You are a prophet. Rise in the glory of that personality. People who are not prophets, who are not godly, who are doing anti-God activities, can assume to be prophets. But those who are really prophets do not want to assume the situation that they are. As soon as you assume, you become. We must today get over this kind of a play our mind has been doing so far. All falsehood has to drop out. Of course, as I said, I could never have dreamt that in 10 years I'll achieve these results. With so many devils around us to entice you. I'm afraid it must go to you people also, that despite all hurdles and problems you had, you have ascended. Ascended so far and have become beautiful prophets. You are so transformed that little more, just to assume what you are, will make you feel so sweet. I talked to my granddaughter, elder one. She is just a little girl, only 11 years of age. But she told her mother, "Now I can't talk to Nani because she's a goddess. How can I talk to her? I feel shy." At that age, while in her own life, as they are saying, she's topped in all the class, she's the editor in a magazine in her school. She's tremendous. And she's so humble that she told her mother, "I feel shy to talk to Nani, she's a goddess, how can I talk to her?" And Rustam told me that there are vibrations emitting from her. That's how you have to go. First of all, you have to know you are prophets, and you must know that I am the Holy Ghost. I am the Adishakti. I am the one who has come on this earth for the first time in this form to do this tremendous task. The more you will understand this, the better it will be. You will change tremendously. I knew I'll have to say that openly one day, and we have said it. But now it is you people who have to prove it, that I am that. Christ had disciples who were not even realized souls, and they have spread Christianity, whatever it is, under such circumstances that Christ was crucified. They were left high and dry. Just 12 people struggling, but they put it up. They were very humble people. Their quality was they are extremely humble. And they knew the difference between them and Christ and the Mother. Also they knew the difference between them and the others. And they took to lives which were pure, illumined by the name of Christ. They were not realized souls. They cleansed themselves and kept their lives beautiful. So Sahaja Yogis can't afford to have these 6 enemies. First of all, the temper, which really doesn't behold compassion. Replace temper with compassion. Today is 60 birthdays, and we have to just fight only 6 enemies within ourselves. Second is, which you have, most of you have done, is to retract your attention from perversion. Most of you have done it. Your eyes are better now, steady. But still, you are egoistic, vanity. Still, people are jealous, competitive. You still have some lurking materialism. A new thing that is coming, you are getting attached to your families. So we have to change it now in a different use. Same thing can be used for doing God's work. They can be used as the six hands of surgery. The first one is the anger. You have to be angry with yourself when you do wrong things. And not to feel guilty, but angry with yourself for doing wrong things. Guilty is the best way never to get rid of it. It's like a storehouse kept for personal archives, locked up. I have suffered a lot because of your guilty business, very much. And they come out one by one. So you have to be angry with yourself when you feel guilty. How can I feel guilty? Why did I do such a thing? I am not going to do it. So develop your anger against yourself and not against others. And anger could be reserved for the day of war. Otherwise, when the war will break out, all the Arjunas will drop their weapons. And it will be said that Arjuna was a great warrior till the war started. So we are not going to waste our energy in warring with things which are just like shadows. Not to fight the shadows. Sex, the perversion has to be diverted towards your family, your wife. And you have to respect your chastity now. The whole thing becomes nothing but chastity. Lead a chaste life. Not to be like a dog, but like to be like a human being. All that attention has to become chastity, which is your power, which is your protection, which is your connection with the Divine. Not forced chastity, but a chastity of balance and understanding with your family, with your wife, in a very chaste way you can live. Same with women. It's more for women, I would say, that they should not join hands with other men who talk against your husbands, or who teach you against your husbands. All such men should be thrown out of Sahaja Yoga who try to tell women against their husbands. This is a very sanctum sanctorum, place where you should not interfere against the husband. Nobody has right. If there is any problem, you should let me know. It's a sign of stupidity. Then the vanity must be made into pride. You should be proud that you are Sahajogis. Really proud. Raise your heads with pride that we are Sahajogis. Pride is never oppressive. It's a glorious thing to be proud. But vanity is. Actually, pride is nothing but the expression of self-esteem. Begging, borrowing, mimicry, all these things come from the less understanding of yourself. So vanity should be the pride, and the pride should be the expression of self-esteem. Self-esteem is very different from ego. One is reality, another is complete artificiality. Men now should behave like men and not like women, docile, like cows to be tied with a rope wherever the women want them to. They have to leave the society. For the women's right in India, the women never fought, it's the men. They never fought, it's the men, because the men are also the fathers, the brothers, and they are concerned about the well-being of women. Women seldom fought there because they knew once they start politics of this fighting with men, there's no end to it. This is basically they knew they have to live with men, they can't fight them. But men themselves fought. Even in America it was Abraham Lincoln who fought for the liberation of women, not women. So you have to be not egoistical but proud. Proud that you are Sahajogis, proud that you are born on such a time when you have to carry on the duties of God's work. That God has chosen you so that you should come up to that level. Like some people I find suddenly become morose, recluses in Sahaja Yoga. They will never be forgiven because God has given you so much. Supposing somebody gives you a diamond, you are proud, and you put it on and show. But when you have been given your spirit, you should be proud and not to behave like recluses. Some people feel I should not do any job now. I'll not go out, I'll sit at home and meditate. There's no place for such people in Sahaja Yoga. I can't do this. The word can't go should go away from the dictionary of people who are supposed to be Sahaja Yogis. They just can't say, I can't do it. So the self-esteem will give you that kind of a dynamism which is needed for Sahaja Yoga, a discreet dynamism, a wise dynamism. I won't have to solve your problems anymore. The quality of competition and jealousy. Should be brought round. There should be competition between yourself, the one you, what you wear and what you are. Who wins? Whether you are past or present. Your present should go fast, faster and faster, leaving this past behind as much as you can. There should be no competition between Sahaja Yogis. in acquisition. Sometimes I have seen also competition in shouting, screaming and being harsh to others. There's a big competition on. Let us have competition in compassion, in mildness, in sweetness, in beautiful behavior. Who is more cultured? Who is more gentlemanly? Who is deeper? Keep somebody an ideal before like that, whom you think is a very gentlemanly person, or a lady who is really like a lady. But on the contrary, if you have a lady who behaves like a man as your ideal, that is also not all right. Or a man who behaves like a woman, that's also not ideal. Or the other way now. A woman who tries to show that women are different from men and women must get this, that is, in Sahaja Yoga there is nothing like women and men, that women must get this and man must get that, because you are spirit. But the cover that you have, the body that you have, the light you have, the lamp that you have, is a different thing. And to keep the light on, a woman has to be a woman and man has to be a man. As I yesterday told you, that an apple should not try to be a mango and mango should not try to be an apple. It looks nice to be the best apple and looks nice to be the best mango. So the recluses, those who say that you want to get out of it, behave really not like human beings, but I think like, I don't know what animals do that way. Like when you get your doles, you cannot become indolent. You cannot. As far as possible, I don't like people taking doles. Not a sign of good Sahaja Yogis. You all should be hardworking, you must have qualifications, you should be good people. On top of it, good students, good cooks, good mothers, good fathers, good administrators. From where are we going to get these people? We cannot be dishwashers, can we? So the competition between women and men must be stopped. Women must have their own place and men must have their own place. And women must know that men are their hands. If you are the Shakti, they are the machines, and don't kill your machine by shouting at them, by screaming at them and by putting them down, making them diffident. You will have no place. You have to encourage them to do God's will. You have to support them, look after them, because they are the machine, they are the hands. And you are the power. Of course, if these hands go against the power, they will suffer. So there should be no competition between children and you. So my child and his child, there should be not such competition. Take out your mind from there. There should be complete sharing. So the competition should end in sharing. How much we share? How much can we share? See, drunkards can't sit and drink alone. They have to have some people to share. The thieves must have 10 people to thieve. But when it comes to the nectar of God's love, how can we alone have it? Cannot enjoy. There's no enjoyment at all. So let us be gentle and kind with each other. the people who are going to enjoy the nectar should have competition in sharing that nectar by which they get more and more of that. Who shares more? Who is more generous? Materialism should be taken to its beauty. You can have one thing done with your hand. That's much more beautiful than running after money, counting money. You'll become crackpots. Really, those who count their money morning till evening are real crackpots. They always lose money, there's something wrong with their brains. Count your blessings. See life, the beauty in matter. How life has worked. See a Buddha, I see the pattern it has created on it, the life. But it's not morose. It's not dead. It's not insipid. It's bubbly. You can see in art, you can see in all that is beautiful, the reflection of God's creative power and the joy that He wanted to emit for your happiness. While you become slaves of matter, He never wanted you to be. You are the masters. Last of all is the attachment to your children, to your wife. Your. Whatever is mine is not I. My house, that's not I. My this, my must be given up. Mamatva is to be destroyed. Instead of that, you should say we. We is a good word. I so many times say we. And people start wondering one day, somebody asked him, Mother, when you say we, what do you mean? How can you make us feel that way, that we are all one? The way you say we, I said, why not? You are part and parcel of my body. Aren't we we? Do I separate my finger from my heart? If you are part and parcel of my body, then I have to talk like we, because I am conscious of this collective being sitting here. So we have to talk like we. And not I, my. And when you have to address about yourself, speak it in a third person. Like you can say, this Nirmala is now going to London. Really, it's true. Because this body is going there, but my heart is going to remain here. So to say that I am going is not true. If I am Adi Shakti, where am I going? I am going nowhere. I am everywhere. Where can I go? There is no place where I don't reside. And if I have to go to such a place, is hell only, where I don't want to go. So, what I say, that this Nirmala is going now, leaving Australia. Tomorrow I'll be. So, what happens? Just this body has to move. That's all. Like that, you start saying about your body. This mind of mine, this mind of Mr. So-and-so, it's better to address yourself Mr. or Mrs. or miss. So, miss, will you please get up now? Better address yourself. Children talk like that, like a third person. You'll be amazed. You will see the joke behind the whole thing. He'll know how to laugh at yourself. Oh, so, mister, come along. Now he's behaving like this. And you'll really become a master of yourself because you know how to handle this baby. It will give you that sense of maturity. So to say, this is my child, this is my wife, of course you have to look after your wife and your children because they are your responsibility. But do for other children more than you would like to do for your own child. There's somebody who has come. So, this complete identification with your children, overprotectiveness, will give you trouble. You have to believe that your family is the family of your father. And your mother is looking after you. If you think you can look after your family by yourself, go ahead. So don't be overprotective, don't be too worried, too upset about your family. And keep a very sociable temperament so that your children also don't become like you. Tell them how to share. If one child has fallen off, ask other children to help. Form plays in which you should show how a child who is coming, who cannot walk properly, how other children go and try and find out methods how to help him to come out. Teach them through dramas, through stories, through various things, what is goodness is. You must help even without the idea of help. It's a pleasure, it's a privilege, it's a great honor that you can do. We must change our ideas completely. Many people have a habit to serve your child first. It's absurd, absolutely very vulgar, shows bad breeding. Must serve others first and then your own family. Keeping something back for your children, hiding some food for your children, is all a sign of a person who is like a kupa manduka, means a frog who lives in a small well. Get over it. Try, men, to form your own group of men, and women should form their group of women. There should be no instruction to women from men too much. It is not proper. I have discovered so many funny things. I can't understand how these things work out. But it is because one side you feed your families too much, your husband is too much, you must be absolutely secluded from all the rest. Or on the other side, it is that you give up your husband completely, he's no good, the marriage is unsuccessful, stick on to something else, which is supposed to be a something higher goal of destruction. So both things are not good. You must stand for your husband or wife or for your children when it is right. But obviously you should not do it. Apparently you should not do it. You should tell your child, all right, I understand. But I don't want to do it in the public. People should not also know that he is your child. The way he mixes up with others, stays with others, shares with others, that's a Sahajyogi should be. You know, as for myself, I have not even given realization to my children so far. Can you believe it? Leave alone the knowledge of Kundalini. You can teach them. I know I can give them any time I want to. I have not given them time at all. No time to them. If you see, how much time do I spend with my own daughters? Very little time. In the whole year, this year I was there for 3 days with them. So the relationship at this time is the most important is of Sahajoga and Sahajogis. I've seen some Sahajogis write to their parents, to their mothers, to their brothers, much more than they write to the other Sahajogis. It's very amazing. To their fathers, but not to other Sahajogis. You must start writing to other Sahajogis. Those who have lived in London, how many of them are writing to people in London? Have they made any friends or anything? Nothing of the kind. They are so busy with their own problems. They are not bothered to create that bondage of love. As if they have no interest in Sahajyoga. They stayed in the ashram in London. How many of you are writing letters to them? To London people. How many letters do you write? Now you have met them in this program. How many of you are writing letters to them and keeping contact? How much does it take to write a letter? Nothing. I hope as soon as you go back today, you all should write letters about today's birthday, how it was celebrated in a beautiful way. Not to your family, not to your people, but to others. All of them are all over. You know how they are. You write to them because you know they are heads of the things. Like if you write to Gregor, or you can write to Ruth in Italy. You can write to Genevieve in Geneva. You have met all of them. You should write. Ladies must write to ladies and men must write to men. Arnaud is in Lausanne. Why not write to him? He's there. Now do you know that his wife has to go to America for a delivery? We should know about each other.
इसी निर्विचार अवस्था में अब हम कुछ क्षण निशब्द ध्यान करते हैं। जय श्री माता जी। श्री माता जी के चरणों पर प्रार्थना अर्पित करते हैं। परम पूज्य श्री माता जी, कृपावंत होकर हमें श्री गणेश जैसा अबोध बनाइए। एक माँ के प्रति जो बच्चे का समर्पण होना चाहिए, ऐसा समर्पण हमें दीजिए। श्री माता जी, आपके चरणों पर कोटि कोटि नमन। अब हम सामूहिक बंधन लेते हैं। आज का ध्यान सत्र यहीं पर समाप्त होता है। जय श्री माता जी।